This is the Eye on Annapolis Daily News Brief, keeping you informed about the happenings in Annapolis and the area. Local news, local sports, local events, local opinion, and of course, local weather. The Eye on Annapolis Daily News Brief starts now.
Good morning. It's Tuesday, February 4th, 2020. This is John Frenay, and this is your Eye on Annapolis Daily News Brief. Yesterday morning at about 6:30 a.m., all hell broke loose on West Street. There was a plume of black smoke, and the Annapolis Fire Department was dispatched to the 2000 block of West Street for a car fire. When they arrived, they discovered not one, but several cars burning in the parking lot of the Annapolis Car Center, which is the used car parking lot at the corner of West and Gibraltar. To complicate the situation, there were several downed electrical wires, as well as some burning utility poles, and crews needed to wait for BG&E to de-energize the lines before they could extinguish the blaze, which they ultimately did using a foam, which actually smothers the fire as opposed to dousing it. Now, because of the electricity was turned off in the area, the Monarch Academy Charter School canceled school for the day. Traffic was disrupted for most of the morning. There were 10 vehicles destroyed, and there is no damage estimate, nor is there a cause of that fire at this point. The Annapolis Police Department is investigating a strange burglary that happened on Friday in the Eastport terrorist community. At about 9 o'clock on Friday, in the 1100 block of Frederick Douglass Street, a female resident of one of the apartments called and said that there was a knock at her door. When she opened the door, a man ran into the home and up the stairs. At that point, she fled the house and called police. When officers arrived, they were unable to locate the suspect. However, she was missing some clothes, as well as two steaks. Strange. Maybe it was a hungry thief. Yesterday afternoon, Mayor Gavin Buckley lost his mother. As we all know, he traveled to Australia last week to be with his mother, who was gravely ill, and yesterday she did pass away. Pauline Brosnan was 77 years old, and she lost her battle with cancer at her home in Fremantle, Australia, with her family by her side. She is survived by her husband, Terry Brosnan, her sister, Annette Butler, the mayor and his family, and she was predeceased by Paul Buckley, who I didn't realize was the twin brother of our Mayor Gavin Buckley. He died at age 14 of an undiagnosed medical condition. Brosnan was born in Limerick, Ireland, moved to London, married, went down to South Africa, where Mayor Buckley and his brother were born, and then finally emigrated into Fremantle in Australia. Her last trip to the USA was to attend Mayor Buckley's inaugural ceremony in December of 2017, and in a statement, Mayor Buckley said, "She was always in my corner, and I will miss her dearly." The mayor will remain in Australia for the burial, and he will return to Annapolis on February 11th. Currently, Alderwoman Rhonda Pendel Charles is the designated acting mayor. If anybody would like to pay their condolences to the mayor's mother, there is a book in the lobby of City Hall at 160 Duke of Gloucester Street. You can stop by there during regular hours and leave a message of sympathy and support. We do send our best wishes, our thoughts, our prayers to Mayor Buckley and his family. It is never easy to lose a parent. And in a rather strange statement coming out of City Hall yesterday, and let me just read this. On February 3rd, 2020, the Annapolis City Council met in an executive session to consider questions raised about the qualifications of our Annapolis Police Chief Edward C. Jackson. We engaged in a full discussion and heard from staff and selection panel members regarding the vetting process. The council has determined, based on the information provided in our meeting, that Chief Jackson exceeds the minimum qualifications as laid out in our charter. The council remains confident in Chief Jackson's ability to do an outstanding job, and a resolution in support of Chief Jackson will be forthcoming from the city council in the coming days. So they went into a secret meeting and they came out and they said, "Oh, we like the chief." Seems sort of strange, but I do think this stems from a report Annapolis Post, which questions the chief's history in Baltimore City Police Department, as well as his non-certification to carry a weapon and make arrests, which apparently is not a qualification to be a police chief. Sort of strange. I think there might be something more to this. We'll keep our eye open. All right, that does it for us today. Please make sure you're checking out eyeonannapolis.net throughout the day, because you can get all of these stories and more as they come in. If you're someplace where you can give us a rating or a review, please do that, because it does help us grow. Other than that, hang tight. We have George Young with your local DMV weather forecast. He's coming up in just 1 minute.
What are we going to do about Mom?
What kind of care does Dad need?
How much will it cost?
Who will take care of them?
These are the tough questions that come with aging parents. Bay Village Assisted Living and Memory Care can help. We have the experience and the resources to help you find those answers, to help you gain peace of mind. We can answer the when, the where, the how, and everything in between. Give us a call or stop by for confidential, free assistance. We're here for those conversations, and maybe it's time you were too. Bay Village Assisted Living and Memory Care, a new community designed with Annapolis in mind. Visit our sales and information center at 947 Bay Ridge Road or online at bayvillageassistedliving.com. We know these are hard conversations, and we're here to help when you need us.
Going out? You need the most up-to-date local weather. Here's George Young from DMV Weather in Annapolis with today's forecast.
Hey everyone, this is George with DMV Weather, and this is your Eye on Annapolis forecast for Tuesday, February 4th. Yesterday was amazing for early February with plenty of sunshine and temps in the 60s for most, and while some showers might move through the region today, temps will again be well above average with highs in the 58 to 65 degree range. But clouds will start to dominate the skies above as a frontal boundary moves toward the area from the west, and showers will become more of a threat on a Wednesday with heavier, steadier rain likely late Wednesday or early Thursday, lasting into much of Friday, with overall rainfall totals, when all is said and done, possibly in the 2 to 4 inch range for the region, with temps in the 50s on Wednesday and mid-40s to maybe low 50s on Thursday and Friday for highs. So get the umbrellas, pullovers, and raincoats ready for action, with the upside being a likelihood for sunshine to return for the weekend ahead for the region. Okay, that's it for today. This is George Young of DMV Weather. Make it a great day out there. And be sure to get our free app on all of your devices by searching the Apple or Google App Stores for DCMDVA Weather. And also follow us on Facebook and Twitter and on our website at dmvweather.com so you can always stay weather informed.
When a ring from the United States Naval Academy comes into Zachary's for a center stone, it always makes us wonder, where's this one going? Where's this one been? A nuclear sub in the North Atlantic? A carrier deck in the South Pacific? The moon? 52 astronauts are Academy graduates, from Iwo Jima to Okinawa, Corregidor to the Coral Sea, Midway to the Persian Gulf, Congress to the White House. These rings go where America goes. 73 that went to war were awarded the Medal of Honor. But wherever they go, wherever they may serve, our admiration goes with them.
Zachary's, online at zacharysjewelers.com. More than a jewelry store, a jeweler.
You've been listening to the Eye on Annapolis Daily News Brief. Tell your friends and colleagues this is the podcast where you can keep up on the latest with what's going on in Annapolis. And also tell them about our website, ionannapolis.net, where you can find even more information. This podcast comes to you every Monday through Friday at 7 a.m., keeping you informed with the Eye on Annapolis Daily News Brief. And take a moment to listen to our other podcast, The Maryland Crabs, released every Thursday at noon.